Hi, and welcome to Calamos Chart Talk. I'm Shawn Park, Director of Product Management and Analytics here at Calamos. Today, I want to discuss a key component to consider when selecting a long-short manager to include in an asset allocation in alternatives. When breaking down the performance of the long-short category, you will notice the difference in returns between top and bottom performance is much wider than traditional asset classes, which typically have smaller differences between product returns. Looking at the one-year period through September 30th, the dispersion between the 10th percentile, which is the highest performer, and 90th percentile, which is the lowest performer, is about 16%. Between the 20th and 80th percentiles, the difference is 8%, and between the 30th and 70th percentiles, a 5% difference. Extending the time period to 3 years, the difference between the 10th and 90th percentile is about 12%, 7% between the 20th and 80th percentile, and 4% between the 30th and 70th percentile. Over 5 years, the difference contracts more, but is still significant. 9% between the 10th and 90th percentile, 6% between the 20th and 80th percentile, and 5% between the 30th and 70th percentile. Because of the flexibility managers have in long-short strategies, much of the out or underperformance attributed to these products is dependent on manager skill. Also, the long-short category is a heterogeneous group of strategies ranging from equity hedge, fundamental long-short, and strategies that use derivatives. Lastly, the category is not clearly defined in regards to style, such as growth or value, and region, such as a focus on U.S. versus international versus emerging market strategies. These differences, and because of the higher dependency on manager skill, the performance within the category varies between top and bottom performers. In conclusion, while there are many attributes an investor in long-short strategies must consider, such as the investment process, the risk-adjusted returns, and how the product fits in an overall asset allocation, an investor must also consider the underlying constituents and the differences between these constituents in the category and how this affects performance. Thank you for joining us today in this installment of Calamos Chart Talk.